Winthrop's cautionary words reverberate throughout Nathaniel Hawthorne's life and prose.
In his stories, Hawthorne stresses the truth in Winthrop's claim that when one sins, his experienced failure becomes a story in itself.
Don't you tell me to deny it. I done wrong and I wanna suffer for my sins.
Through the brooding romantic perspective that plagued his personal life and his astute societal awareness, Nathaniel Hawthorne projects himself onto the Scarlet Letter's Hester Prynne, thereby illustrating that physical acknowledgement of sin to the societal eye stands paramount when seeking redemption.
By refuting fundamental transcendentalist views of human nature, yet romanticizing sin, Hawthorne casts a brooding romantic perspective onto Hester Prynne that asserts man's capacity for redemption.
Nathaniel Hawthorne's anti-transcendentalist perspective has roots in his own tainted past. His great-grandfather, John Hawthorne, was a Puritan judge who presided over the Salem witch trials. Another relative, Major William Hawthorne, was a fervent persecutor of Salem's Quakers who did not share his Puritan ideals.
In order to disassociate with a past that warped his otherwise pure identity, Nathaniel added the W to his inherited surname, becoming Hawthorne by age 24.
We'll never come. Oh, help me, but don't tell me to deny it. I gotta cleanse myself of all these loves till I'm good enough for him.
He never truly moves forward into a mindset unaffected by the past,
or without the weight of themes like inherited guilt and the consequential innate sinfulness of man.
Hester's character, consequently, shares much the same outlook as Hawthorne,
which is extremely progressive in comparison with the Puritan society in which he places Hester.
Hawthorne embraces the romantic emphasis on emotion and individuality, which allows him to relate his darker literary themes to society's transcendentalist outlook. However, he does not see individuality and emotion as completely positive forces.
Emotion ultimately results in the sin of the individual.
Sin inevitably provokes a guilty conscience.
One only finds relief through acknowledgement of the sin to society. Hester and Hawthorne do take this critical initiative to sidestep a life of guilt and seek redemption.
But they still remain products of their pasts.
Through his ability to express the consternation of man grappling with sin, and his emphasis of the dependence on society's gaze in order to attain personal peace, Nathaniel Hawthorne illustrates the importance of physical retribution for one's sins when seeking redemption.
One never experiences Hester's sin firsthand. Instead, Hawthorne employs the townspeople who surround Hester to impart her guilt.
The public gaze provides verification.
The Scarlet Letter evolves from being a symbol of her sins to a representation of Hester's new public persona.
But the power of a single symbolic letter grants freedom not only to Hester Prynne. Nathaniel Hawthorne attempts to fundamentally alter his identity and eradicate the acts he disapproved of done by his forefathers in the Salem witch trials by adding a single letter W to his name, changing not only the spelling, but also the public's perception of him.
It matters not whether one pins a metaphorical letter to his own chest or has it placed there by another, the end result remains the same.
The physical citation of wrongdoing illustrates to society that one realizes fault, and the societal acknowledgement of this fact lets the subject restructure their identity.
Hester Prynne atones for her sins with her needle, stitching together a new role for herself by aiding others, while Hawthorne utilizes his pen, atoning for the perceived wrongdoing of his ancestors by authoring his works reflective on Puritanism.
Through these lines, Hawthorne preempts his novel by defining the governing philosophy of his prose. He recognizes the fundamentality of sin, imparting that one either seeks personal liberation and redemption through physical imprisonment by the public gaze, or one carries the guilt of unacknowledged sin to the grave.
Hester epitomizes the former and demonstrates Hawthorne's ultimate hope for his own life.
Paperback writer!